I was fascinated to come on this trip with my friend Gustavo at Andy's Drifters because it sort of harkened back to something that I was chasing ever since I was a boy. I grew up in my generation reading Jack London and Thoreau, and I had always dreamed, harbored this dream of finding some place that no one had ever been before. And as a young man in my 20s, I took off and drove across country. I fished all through British Columbia. I fished in the Yukon. I ended up in Alaska, and I spent 6 years up there fishing and exploring and searching river systems. And I found some fantastic places, but I don't think I ever found a place where no one had ever really been before. And now, at this time in my life, I find myself living in Patagonia. I've been here 12 years. And I still have the same fantasy. And this river system that we just explored comes very, very close to that childhood dream. It was extraordinary because we've spent 2 days getting back into the river and see virtually no signs of any other humans ever having been here before. I caught my first fish 55 years ago, and I've spent a lifetime fishing. Over those years, I've caught untold tens of thousands of fish, and it's not always just the fish, but it's usually the circumstances surrounding the catch. And we had one of those moments yesterday afternoon. It was extraordinary. We had had a long day in this absolutely pristine wild river that we had come into as a with a group, Gustavo and Gonzalo from Andy's Drifters. I had a chance to join them on this incredible river that had been basically unfished. Very late in the day, we came to this crystal clear pool, and I stepped up and made a single cast with a dry fly. And at the bottom of the pool, an absolutely enormous brown trout rose, sniffed my fly, and then refused it and turned back to the bottom of the pool.
It's enorme.
Big brown.
And immediately, Gustavo hands me his rod and says, "I've got a different fly, try this one real quick." So I take his rod, I make one more cast, and in precisely the same position, the same brown comes up off the bottom, chases the fly, sniffs it, and then refuses it again. And now, behind him is Gonzalo. And Gonzalo's got his rod tied with another fly, and he hands it forward. We have a chain now of rods coming to me. Try this one. So I cast his fly, which was a mouse fly, skated it through the pool, and again, this enormous brown comes up from the bottom, chases the fly, sniffs it closely, and then refuses it and turns to the bottom. So now we've gone through three different refusals, and by this time, Gonzalo has got my original rod and he's tying a new fly on and passes it back forward and says, "Go at him again." So I make another cast, it drifts through, and in the same spot, a brown comes up and takes it, but it's not the same fish.
Another fish.
And by this time, we think, okay, the big guy who's laying on the bottom is gone. But we're catching nice fish. So we take two more steps forward and I cast what is the fourth fly now back to the head of the pool. And here comes this enormous brown up one more time and sips it straight off the surface.
Further to the left, I think. Okay. Wait, ooh. Sit! Ooh, look at the water! Look at the water!
Ooh,
you know!
It's Lisa, it's Lisa, it's Lisa.
Let it go. Right to the right, right to the right.
We had an absolutely incredible fight. There were four of us working in tandem, trying to take this fish. It was truly a team effort.
Oh shit! It's really big.
And we landed this fish, and I think all of us are going to remember this fish for the lifetime, because it was one of those moments where it wasn't just the fish, but it was all these circumstances leading up to taking the fish, and all the people involved. And undoubtedly, it's actually the people that I spend time on the river with who bring me back places. And I'll remember this fish for a lifetime, and I'll remember the guys that I caught it with for a lifetime.